Simply put, cryptocurrency is digital money. Unlike traditional money, it isn't kept in banks or printed at a mint.
Instead, it's all online, with every transaction stored in a database called a blockchain,
which is a group of connected computers that keep a record of every time someone sends or receives crypto.
Digital money has been around for a while, but Bitcoin is considered the original cryptocurrency, founded in 2009 by a programmer, or possibly a group of programmers, under the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto.
But there are other types of cryptocurrency.
Just like paper money, cryptocurrency can be used to buy goods and services, as long as the seller is willing to accept it.
It's become a popular way for young people to raise money in support of causes they believe in.
Like in Nigeria last year, when organizers of the hashtag #EndSARS protest collected donations in crypto, protecting the funds from being seized by the government.
Because crypto transactions can't be traced by authorities, there is a fear that they might be used for criminal activities, like to pay for drugs or weapons.
And although a lot of people are clamoring to own crypto, there is a risk that they could lose their value or be hacked and stolen.
This is because they're unregulated, which means there are no laws protecting people who choose to invest in them.
Then there is the environmental impact. Mining, the process by which new cryptocurrencies are added into the blockchain database, uses a lot of energy.
There are now whole factories dedicated to mining cryptocurrency, with thousands of computers working round the clock to keep the blockchain running.
Some people say cryptocurrency is the future of money. And if what we've seen in places like music or TV and film are anything to go by, then this isn't necessarily a wrong assumption.
But there will probably have to be some policies put in place to make sure it's safe and fair for everyone to use before that happens.